Essentially, when we look at single nucleotide polymorphisms, we're looking at little snippets of genetic material that the body translates into functional enzymes. And enzymes are catalysts that run reactions in the body, basically turning X into Y, X into Y, X into Y. And it doesn't matter if X is a pre-neurotransmitter and Y is a neurotransmitter, or X is a pre-hormone and Y is a actual hormone, or X could be some toxin as such and we're making it water soluble or fat soluble. It doesn't matter. Enzymes catalyze reactions. So all single nucleotide polymorphisms, for our purposes, are the code of genetic material that is supposed to be translated that enzyme. And if you have abnormalities that you inherit from mom or dad or both, so a homozygous, which is two copies, plus plus, you inherited, an abnormality of sorts from mom and dad. Heterozygous is mom or dad, that's plus minus. A lot of us have similar systems breaking down, whether it's our digestive system, our immune system, neurochemistry collapse, because that's where the depression and anxiety and everything comes from. We all have very similar aspects of our physiology that aren't working as well as they used to. Hormone imbalances, endocrine system fully, thyroid, adrenal system, all of these things are very common from person to person. The sympathetic nervous system being in overdrive, or there being a significant balance between that sympathetic and that parasympathetic, fight or flight versus rest and digest. A lot of people in the room can relate to that. The wonderful thing about doing this from a precision medicine perspective is that we're trying to answer the question, why and how, for you specifically. The key to precision medicine is really this. These are all physiological pathways. In fact, the same physiological pathways that the drug companies study to get their blockbuster medicines. We've known about these physiological pathways for quite a long time. Medicine in its primitive era has known about it. The key to precision medicine isn't new information. It's going back to the root information, and now the ability to get some of the details in between in terms of who we are genetically, and then putting that together in a very careful way. That's why you can't just go to a website, punch in a few SNPs, and have a supplement recommendation spit out and buy their products on their online stores and get anything from it, unless you are the simplest of the simplest patients. And for them, congratulations. But for most part, people have been at this for a while, they've been struggling, they've been working with a lot of different clinicians. The way that you're gonna do this is patiently, methodically, step by step. You gotta build the foundation before you put up the walls. You gotta put up the walls before you put up the roof. And like that, if you go through those motions, and you don't look for that immediate gratification, you can figure out who you are genetically, and you can fix it. Now what we're doing is we're taking what makes you unique and defining how you in particular got to that same final common pathway that so many people have also gotten to through their own mechanisms. And that's where we try to intervene in a very precise way, hence the description precision medicine. So we look at single nucleotide polymorphisms as what's unique about you that might not be optimal, and we analyze those completely. But more than that, we just understand that there's also going to be biological clues along the way in your urine, in your blood, in your saliva that's going to demonstrate that that genetic that we're seeing actually means something and it's clinically relevant that we address it in order to get you feeling better. And from my perspective, what we're doing is we're going to the deepest levels possible, short of getting into the bioenergetics. We're really going down to the molecular chemistry level, and we're trying to understand what unraveled at this level that ultimately impacted your immune system, your digestive system, your neurochemical balance, your hormones. Because the truth is that no matter how things go awry at that molecular level, we all end up in the same place. Our digestive systems, our immune systems, our neurochemistry, right? In general, people pop up all over the place specializing in one or more things that will help assist someone to, say, heal their digestive system, heal their immune system. You know, someone who specializes in treating Lyme, or someone who specializes in treating mold toxicity, or yeast, or Epstein-Barr. I mean, is all you have to do is Google the internet, and you'll see that there are many specialists that have dedicated their whole life to, you know, something like chronic fatigue. Well, what the awareness of precision medicine is doing for us now is it's helping us understand that that's probably not the best way to go about it, because it never is just one thing. It's multifactorial. And what sits at the crux of what it really is who you are, your genetic susceptibilities. But then again, you can't just look at genetic susceptibilities and say, that's the answer. Because genetic susceptibilities are exactly that. They're just susceptibilities. You need medical testing to demonstrate whether or not they're meaningful or not. We take that information, which we can get. Depending on what I see there, we might order a point mutation test looking for deeper explanations. For instance, why mitochondria are not working, or why your nervous system doesn't seem to produce neurotransmitters optimally. Does that make sense? But we're going to take that genetic information, we're going to sit there, and we're going to say, this is you, because it is you. But then what we're going to do is we're going to cross-reference it to a number of functional medicine tests. And we're going to look for essentially all the metabolics that we can find, whether it's the metabolics coming off of the neurotransmitter pathways like HIAA, VMA, HVA, breakdown of epinephrine, norepinephrine, serotonin, or, for instance, looking at blood homocysteine to demonstrate, you know, the clinical relevance of things like the early methylation single nucleotide polymorphisms. Either way, we can't just look and say, oh, you're homozygous MTHFR, and make a bunch of clinical decisions around that. That's asking for trouble, because you never know if someone's over-methylated, under-methylated, or just fine. Because a genetic susceptibility is just a genetic susceptibility. You need the medical testing to demonstrate that it's clinically relevant. You see, leave no stone unturned is really what we need to do, and especially in the initial time frame we're working together, we're spending a lot of time together, and I don't compromise. People will say, well, can we spend less time? And the answer is no, because we are going to hopefully define so thoroughly the plan of action that we'll outline all these steps. We'll be very clear on exactly what we need to do and in what order. It's kind of like which domino you flip so all the dominoes fall easily.